Hi, in this session, we are going to discuss some basic calculations that you can do using your R. So let's get started. This is the R Studio, which I'm going to use. Now, the basic calculations that you can do could be something like this. Let's get started and see, for instance, 2 plus 2, you get it 4, right? Same way, similarly, a multiplication, 2 multiplied by 3, you get 6. Similarly, let us do a division. Let us say 8 divided by 2 gives me 4. Okay? Similarly, if I want to do some log values, let us say log of 10, it gives me 2.302. Likewise, if I want to shift it to base 10, log of 10, 10, you get 1. If I need some exponents, for instance, 2 raised to the power 4. So you have 16. You can do the same thing by putting 2 asterisks, 2 double asterisks, and 4. You get the same thing. So this way you can perform some basic calculations. Now there could be a need to save these calculations, to perform these calculations again. So how do we go ahead with that? Let's try to see how to do that. Okay, so this was my console. I moved to my editor. This is my editor. You can start a new script by clicking on this plus icon. So a new R script. Okay, so I have another new R script where I can start this, or I can just use my previous page. Okay, so now let me get started. I'll do the same calculations which I performed over here. Let us say 2 plus 2. Okay, 2 plus 2. Now you would see that I'm not getting any output. Okay, 4 minus 3. I did not get any output. Similarly, let us say 2 multiplied by 3. No output. Let us do a division. 8 divided by 2. Okay. Let us do a log. Log of 10. Then I will go for base 10. Okay. Similarly, an exponent. No output, right? So you would see that once I did all these calculations in the console, I was getting all the outputs. But at this point of a time, when I wrote the same things, I'm not getting any output for the same. Okay, so I'll show you why and how. Okay, now once you write your calculations in your editor, you have the option of running all of them together. So how do you run them? You select all of them, okay, and then you have this run tab over here. So once you click on this, you would see all these calculations get executed at a go. Similarly, you can perform each calculation once at a time. Just click on the line and run individual lines. So you would see 2 plus 2 gives me 4. 4 minus 3 gives me 1. So this way you can run individual lines as well. Okay. Now, if I just hover my cursor over here, you would see that it gives me a prompt that I can use a keyboard shortcut Control plus Enter. Because, you know, when you are using for extended projects, every time shifting from your keyboard and the mouse, it makes things complicated. So learn to use the keyboard shortcuts. Now, let me run this using my keyboard shortcut. So control enter together gives me 16. Okay, so in the forthcoming commands, whatever we use, I would be using this control enter. Just simply push control plus enter. Now, at times you may also require to store these calculations in some objects. To give you a perspective of what I'm talking about, let me just take you to an Excel and let us see what I'm just talking about. This is my Excel. Now, for instance, let me name this cell and create a variable over here. Okay, so I just make a right click and I go to define name, and I'm naming this as X, for instance, and I say okay. It says the name already exists. Okay, maybe I did some previous calculation. Let us say I'm making a name called A. So now I've created this name for this, and when I click on this cell, you can see that I have A displayed over here. Now let me make a calculation. For instance, let us say I say equals, select this cell and multiply it by 3. What am I trying to do? I'm trying to store some value in the cell in an object called A, and I want an output in this cell that whatever the values is presented in this cell, I should get the multiple of 3 in this particular cell. So now, for instance, let us say I insert 3 in this cell, I get an output of 9. Likewise, if I insert 4 over here, I get 12. Got the idea? Now I would like to do the same thing by creating an object in R. Okay, now let us say A. I would say A is equal to, for instance, right now 3. Okay, so let me run this, control plus enter. Now you would see that I get the same operation in console, A equals 3. You see that in the environment, an object is created, A as 3. Now I can perform any calculation, say A multiplied by 4, control plus enter to run, you can see 12. So what we did in Excel, we tried to do the same thing in R as well. Okay, so but that was the reason why I took you to Excel to build the context for that. There could be another case where you need to do some calculations using a variable. Now, to understand that, let's go back to our Excel and try to understand what we are talking about. For instance, in Excel, any variable is nothing but just a column. Now, let me give a name variable V1. So let me just insert a few numbers. Okay, now I have a variable in which I have some values like 1, 2, and 3. And if I want to initiate a calculation, for instance, let us say I want to find the sum of these 3 numbers. So I write sum and I select these 3, close my parenthesis, hit enter, I get the sum as 6. Now, if I wish to do the same thing in R, how do I do that? Okay, so I need to create a variable now called V1. I would say equals. You could write equals, or you could also use this symbol less than and minus. Okay, so V1 equals or less than minus. And I would create a vector. And how do I create a vector? I use the C function. Okay, C could be combine or concatenate. So the values were 1, 2, and 3. I run this, control plus enter. You could see the same thing in your environment now. V1 has been created. and the values 1, 2 and 3 okay, are created. Now let us go back to our Excel. Now just say, for instance, I calculated the sum. I would like to find the sum of this vector. Let us do it. So simply what you can do is sum. I would say V1. I get the sum. Okay, I hit Control plus Enter. Calculation is performed and I get the sum. Now, for instance, let us say I want to do something else. Okay, now let us see. I have this variable and I want the multiples of 3. Okay, so I can simply say equals, select this cell and multiply by 3. Hit enter. Now you would see when I just simply drag it down, I get all the values which are multiplied by 3. Okay, 1 multiplied by 3 is 3, 2 multiplied by 3 is 6, 3 multiplied by 3 is 9. I would like to perform the same thing in R. Now just simply what you need to do is 3 multiplied by, okay, V1. Now when I hit Control plus Enter together, you could see I got the values 3, 6 and 9. Okay, so it's quite handy, quite simple. At times there could be a situation where you may need to operate on two different variables. Okay, now how do we do that and what is the context? Let's try to understand. I'm just removing these. Now let us say I have another variable called V2. Now in V2 I have 2, 3 and 6, or 4, let us say. Now I need to have the, let us say, sum, or let us say division, okay, is equal to 1 divided by, okay, this cell divided by this. The same thing should happen with all the values in both the variables. Okay, now this is what I have performed, a division. Okay, that is V1, that is variable 1, is divided with the values present in V2. I wish to do the same thing in R. Let's do it. So in this case, I will have to create another variable. So I'm making another variable. For instance, let us say the values could be 2, 3, 6. So let us run this. Now another variable, you could see V2 has been created over here. That's it. Now I need to perform that calculation of division. So V1 divided by V2. Now run, that is Control plus Enter. You could see I have the values. Okay, so these are some of the basic calculations. Now one thing to keep in mind, that when we are creating these variables and performing certain calculations using these variables, you need to have these variables of equal length. Okay, first of all, let us try to understand what is length. For instance, let us say I need to check the length of variable 1, okay, that is 3. So the length means the number of elements that are present in that value or variable. Now in variable 1, you could see I have values, 3 values, 1, 2 and 3. Likewise, the length of V2, I have the same length, that is 3. That means there are 3 elements. You could see 2, 3 and 6. Now if I create another variable, let us say V3, which has values 4, 6, 7, 9. Okay, so I have created, you could see I have V3. Okay, I have 4 elements of that. Let me check the length. Now when I check the length, you could see the length is 4. Okay, So you have to keep it in mind when you are performing calculations using two variables, the length needs to be same. Let me perform a multiplication of V2 and V3. V2 multiplied by V3. You can see that I get a warnings message. In V2 multiplied by V3, longer object length is not a multiple of shorter object length. So as I told you, the problem is both the variables need to be of equal length. Here I have variable 2, that is V2 of length 3 and V3 of length 4. That is one problem. Okay, so this way you need to keep it in mind. That's the word of caution that you need to remember. So I have understood, or I tried to explain you how to perform various calculations using just numbers or with variables. Now, whatever variables or objects that you have created and stored in your global environment, you can remove them as well by just simply using the rm function. Now I want to remove the element or object A. So just simply say rm A, run it. So you could see A is removed. And let us say if I want to remove multiple objects at a time, I could simply say rm V1, comma, use a comma V2 and V3. I want to remove all the three. Okay. So you could see I've removed variable 1, variable 2 and variable 3, all of them. So my environment is empty. Fine. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.